After over a decade of being trapped in production limbo, this house has finally been painted. Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we'll be counting down our picks for the top 10 things the critics are saying about The Irishman.
Big business and the government are working together, trying to pull us apart.
Something's gotta be done.
For this list, we're taking a look at the critical buzz surrounding this epic crime drama based on the life of Frank the Irishman Sheeran.
I got that kid I was talking to you about here.
Number 10, it's gonna be a major awards contender.
Hiya, Frank. Would you like to be a part of history?
Yes, I would.
Whenever Martin Scorsese is attached to a picture, you can expect it to be in the Oscar conversation. As surprising as it might sound, Scorsese has only won one Academy Award for The Departed, which is also his only film to win Best Picture.
Thank you, sir. Good luck.
Reviews seem to indicate that the Academy might correct this with The Irishman. Owen Gleiberman of Variety wrote, "The Irishman has now all but guaranteed Netflix a central place at the awards table, in the same way that Roma did last year."
Point the gun down when you're not using it.
While Roma was Netflix's biggest Oscar winner to date, one award it couldn't achieve was Best Picture. Of course, if there's one filmmaker who can finally bring the streaming service Hollywood's most prestigious prize, it's Mr. Scorsese.
It's gonna happen. Either way, he's going.
Number 9. Scorsese plus source material equals perfect match.
Hey, my friend. I got that kid I was talking to you about here. I'm gonna put him on the phone and let you talk to him, okay?
Sometimes when you read a book, you can immediately envision who should direct the film adaptation. For anyone who picked up the memoir I Heard You Paint Houses, Martin Scorsese was likely the first name that came to mind.
I heard you paint houses.
No, please, no, no, please.
Yes, I do, sir.
As it turns out, these two go together about as well as one would hope. Throw in screenwriter Steven Zalian, who previously adapted Schindler's List, and you have an unbeatable formula. Quote, "The Irishman features an ideal match of filmmaker and source material," IndieWire's Eric Cohn hailed in his review. Cohn proceeded to say that this, quote, "faithful adaptation provides a definitive template for Scorsese's best kind of character study."
Frank Sheeran. Am I saying that right?
Yeah, you said it right.
Frank Sheeran certainly wouldn't feel out of place sitting around the table with Henry Hill and Tommy DeVito.
Yeah, I went for 7,000, they charge me.
Number 8. It's long, but worth it.
You can't miss the big picture.
Between Avengers Endgame and Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, we've seen some pretty lengthy movies in 2019.
It's my stunt double, Cliff Booth.
Last night, we watched a Rick Dalton double feature.
All the shooting.
I love that stuff, you know, with the killing.
A lot of killing.
The Irishman takes the cake, however, clocking in at a reported 209 minutes.
Sooner or later.
Get the gun out of his hand!
Everybody put here has a date when he's gonna go.
While no critic would deny that the film is long, the final result is ultimately rewarding. Vulture's David Edelstein felt the film, quote, "doesn't fully earn its epic running time, but it's overlong, it's not overscaled." Johnny Oleksinski of the New York Post suggested that his readers, quote, "chug a 5-hour energy because the terrific Irishman deserves your full, unfatigued attention." The question is whether a film of this scale and length will be more susceptible to audiences in a theater or from the comfort of home. Owen Gleiberman thinks that might be the movie's biggest problem.
You gotta sit down, everybody says so.
No, I'm not sitting down, I can't do it!
Number 7, it has an amazing final act.
What else you say?
At almost 3.5 hours, The Irishman did leave a few critics restless at times. Even if the film isn't without its slower moments, critics are definitely glad that they stayed put for the final act, where Frank Sheeran's character arc comes full circle.
It was like the army. You followed orders. You did the right thing. You got rewarded.
Quote, "it's only as the film enters its final devastating chapters that the full weight of Frank's actions begin to register as something more than names on a coroner sheet," wrote Leah Greenblatt of Entertainment Weekly. Stephanie Zaharik shared a similar sentiment, saying, quote, "the final 30 minutes of the movie show what happens when he does, and even then, whatever reckoning he does is happening deep behind his eyes, and his gaze holds us."
Where are you going?
Going to work.
Number 6, the de-aging is just a bit distracting.
Under the contract, management can only fire a driver on very specific charges. So, you have a show up late.
No.
One of the most talked about aspects of the film is the digital de-aging technology used to knock a few decades off Robert De Niro and company. The Rap's Alonzo Duralde was quite taken with the de-aging, calling it, quote, "beautifully rendered" and, quote, "nearly flawless." David Rooney of The Hollywood Reporter was a little less quick to praise the effect, writing, quote, "it's distracting only on initial impact, and for the most part easy enough to accept De Niro, Pacino, and Pesci playing characters 20 or 30 years younger than them."
Well, you know, there's a situation going on now, Frank.
While it also took A.O. Scott of the New York Times a while to get used to the effect, he ultimately felt, quote, it doesn't take you out of the picture any more than makeup or prosthetics might.
You might be demonstrating a failure to show appreciation.
Number 5, it has echoes of Clint Eastwood's work.
We gotta go! Get the gun out of his hand!
While a majority of the reviews have compared The Irishman to Scorsese's past works, a few have drawn parallels to another A-list filmmaker, Clint Eastwood.
I don't deserve this. To die like this. I was building a house.
Deserves got nothing to do with it.
The AV Club's A.A. Dowd wrote, quote, The Irishman reminded me a bit of Unforgiven. It feels at last like a critical eulogy for an era of crime fiction that Scorsese and De Niro and Pacino built, apart and sometimes together. Likewise, Matt Zoller Seitz of RogerEbert.com called the film's final act, quote, an immersion into a now old man's life, fuller than we're used to seeing in any American movie not directed by Clint Eastwood.
What else you say? Now's not the time to not say.
With that in mind, The Irishman could make for a strong double feature with Eastwood's latest movie, Richard Jewell.
I want you to say there's a bomb in Centennial Park. You have 30 minutes.
Number 4, welcome back, Joe Pesci.
I want you to meet my cousin, Russell Buffalino.
How are you?
Hi, nice to meet you.
Joe Pesci was among the most prominent character actors in the business throughout the 80s and 90s. Since the beginning of the 21st century, though, he's only appeared in 2 live-action films, The Good Shepherd and Love Ranch, the latter of which came out in 2010.
This is the greatest revenue-generating machine in the world.
We've been eager to see this acting powerhouse make a comeback, and The Irishman sees Pesci return in a big way.
Things have gotten out of hand with our friend.
His role in this Scorsese collaboration isn't just a retread of the hot-headed characters we've seen him previously play, however. The Guardian's Benjamin Lee found Pesci's performance to be a breath of fresh air, writing, quote, he's rational and professional, much like the film's plot, which eschews the brash debauchery of Goodfellas or Casino for something far more grounded.
It's what it is.
What it is.
Number 3, Robert De Niro is awesome.
Glad to meet you.
Glad to meet you too, even if it's over the phone.
From Taxi Driver to Raging Bull, you can never go wrong when Scorsese and Robert De Niro team up.
You talking to me? You talking to me?
With exception to a short film entitled The Audition, though, we haven't seen Scorsese direct De Niro in a project since Casino in 1995. Since then, De Niro's kept busy doing comedies like Dirty Grandpa. The Irishman not only reunites this actor and director, but also sees a return to form for De Niro. Stephanie Zaharik proclaimed, De Niro gives his best performance in years. With zero mugging or scowling, his Frank is a man of action who's so busy doing bad stuff, he barely has time to think.
Do you drink on the job?
No.
You ever hit anybody?
On a job?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
All right, then. We don't have nothing to worry about.
De Niro could very well be looking at his first Best Actor nomination since Cape Fear.
They're committed to their professions and to their ambitions, but they're not committed to each other.
Number 2, it's a major comeback for Al Pacino.
I know things they don't know I know.
Al Pacino is another phenomenal actor whose career has gone through some turbulence in recent years.
Compliments to Mr. Pacino.
What the?
2019 is inclined to go down as a comeback year for Pacino with his supporting role in Once Upon a Time in Hollywood and especially his turn as Jimmy Hoffa in The Irishman.
Hello?
Is that Frank?
Yes.
Hiya, Frank. This is Jimmy Hoffa.
Salon's Gary M. Kramer is one of the many critics who have singled him out as a Best Supporting Actor favorite, saying, quote, he's also absolutely pitch perfect, stealing every scene and giving arguably the film's best performance. He's a shoo-in for an Oscar nomination, if not the award itself. Believe it or not, this would only be Pacino's second Oscar. Even more unbelievable, this is the first collaboration between Pacino and Scorsese.
You always charge a guy with a gun. With a knife, you run away. So you charge with a gun, with a knife you run.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1, it's classic Scorsese.
He likes the tough, don't he?
The Irishman is like a showcase for several legendary talents at the top of their game. As incredible as De Niro, Pacino, and Pesci are, the real star of the film is Scorsese's direction.
Only 3 people in the world have one of these. And only one of them is Irish.
Exactly how does this crime epic stack up against the rest of his filmography, though? As far as Eric Cohn is concerned, The Irishman is Scorsese's best crime movie since Goodfellas, and a pure, unbridled illustration of what has made his filmmaking voice so distinctive for nearly 50 years. Screen International Stephen Whitty called the film, quote, vintage Scorsese, with an often sinuously moving camera, occasional break the fourth wall monologues, wicked wise guy humor, and explosions of sudden tenderness and casual violence. Even in his 70s, Scorsese is churning out masterpieces.
What do you want to know? You want to know if I did it or not? No.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojo and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.